What's good, everybody? Don't look too close at this hair. It's wash day and we're gonna clear the air about hair care, specifically shampoos. If you have ever used and bought a shampoo, and I really hope that you do, or if you've ever watched me here on this channel, you may have seen that there are many, 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 many types of shampoo, and no, there is not just one out there for you, but hopefully two or three, depending. I can tell you, as a hair care professional and hairstylist that has dealt with every type of hair, there is not one universal product out there. You see, there are so many different types of shampoo for different types of reasons, different hair types, and that's exactly what we're gonna go over in today's video. That way, if you have been having any reservations about what type of shampoo to use for your hair type, by the end of this video, hopefully you will be able to choose, or at least gain some tips and tricks on how to actually use your shampoos as I get in the shower and show you. I'm so excited. In the words of Lizzo, I've been waiting for this one. So without further ado, allow me to show you how to use your shampoos.
Turn it up!
There are different shampoos for oily, dry, coarse, fine, flat, limp, thin, thick, color treated, chemically treated, damaged, and more. All for you to choose from. But yet, it's not quite what these shampoos can do for you and your hair type, but what you can get out of which shampoo you're using. For example, although most shampoos are made to remove impurities like dirt and dust and oil and product, minerals even, some shampoos are made to add to the hair. Therefore, I would personally categorize different shampoos into these categories. Category one would be your gentle cleansing and refreshing. Then you have your clarifying shampoos. Then there's chelating shampoos. They're different, they're built different. And finally, there would be the specialty shampoos like color shampoos, treatment shampoos, and I would also throw in the dry shampoos. All of which we will go over throughout this video. After I choose what I will use to shampoos to do. Ow! I really like this. So, let's evaluate my situation. My hair has got lots of product buildup, lots of oils, creams, gels, sunscreens. It's got the whole nine yards, so I need a good, deep clean, clarifying. And I'm going to use something that has a little bit of extra exfoliating just to help treat my scalp as well. So I'm gonna go deep poo, and in the meantime, she will explain to you why you can't just rely on water. Well, hi, Scientific Melly here to talk about hair because we care about getting nitty gritty and okay, yes, shampoos. Water versus shampoo. What can each of them do? Well, water will be effective at washing away things like dirt, dust, and essentially other debris in our hair that are water soluble, like our sweat. However, when it comes to things like our sebum, which are the oils from our scalp, you need to think about the relationship that water and oil have. They don't like to mix. And so, when it comes to removing things from your scalp and hair that are oil soluble, like your sebum and like many products that contain oils and butters, if cleansing is the goal, you will need to be using a shampoo. That's because shampoos contain special molecules called surfactants. See? We don't lie. Surfactants are actually attracted to oil. And when it comes to things like the removal of sebum, with surfactants, one end is attracted to water, while the other end is attracted to oil. That end that's attracted to the oil will attract the oil in your hair, swallow it up, and then through the motion of emulsifying and cleansing with the water, they're able to rinse away together from the hair, leaving you clean. Now, if you have ever taken a look at your shampoo bottle, you may have seen some very common surfactant ingredients. For example, the most common surfactant, detergent, that is, meant for cleansing, are the sulfate variety. But sulfates aren't the only type of surfactant cleansers that can be found in shampoos, and they also may not be the only ones that you want to use. Each of these detergents have different functions, and they work to remove different types of soils from your hair in different ways, and so taking another look at your ingredient list will help you determine which type of detergent in your shampoo will give you the cleansing results that you are looking for. It's the ingredients, they're key.
Wow. Slow clap that one out. That was beautifully and scientifically said, Melly.
Thank you for that. And I do have to say that I feel a million times better now that I have de-soiled myself. But let's talk about which shampoo you may want to pick based on what your hair needs are, what you need to know about these types of cleansers, and how often to use them. Our gentle cleansers are the ones that you may want to reach for if your hair and scalp is more on the dry side and you are not looking for any excessive cleansing. Now, if this is the case, I am assuming that you're not applying a lot of product. Because the thing about gentle cleansers is they'll only be able to remove so much on your hair without, for example, having to use the whole bottle. A gentle cleanser would be a moisturizing shampoo, a conditioning shampoo or conditioning wash, co-wash, literally the cleansers that do look like conditioner. And you can also classify most sulfate-free cleansers in the gentle, mild cleanser range. That being said, a sulfate-free category is a very broad spectrum. There can be some very cleansing and chelating sulfate shampoos, but for the most part, the sulfate-free cleansers that we see all over the place being advertised, especially to curlies, are much more conditioning and milder. And these are gonna be great if you have a really dry hair and scalp that doesn't have a lot of natural oils, because using these is gonna ensure that you don't remove the few oils that your hair does have. Gentle cleansers can be a little more difficult to work with because they are so creamy. Sometimes you need to add a little extra water when you are emulsifying and working them into your hair, and you will notice that they don't typically foam up as much as a typical clarifying cleansing shampoo. These types of cleansers are great to use if you wash your hair very frequently and you are afraid of drying out your ends, washing out your color so quick, and even drying out your scalp, because again, they are much more gentle. But these are not to be used alone. They cannot do it all. We'll get to what other shampoos you may also want to use. But for daily use, if you feel like your hair and scalp, again, it's dry, you're just looking for something very gentle, using a cream-based gentle conditioning wash is going to be the right type of cleanser for you that day. But that does not mean that you can skip out on clarifying. Our clarifying shampoos are honestly a really bit of a tricky subject, because regular cleansing shampoos are categorized as clarifying shampoos, but in my world, a true clarifying shampoo is actually chelating. It's a step up. But if you are someone that's looking for a shampoo that's gonna better effectively cleanse away product buildup as well as oils, so especially if you have an oily scalp, using our clarifying cleansers that do typically contain some sulfate ingredients, you are gonna have a much better time at effectively cleansing your hair and scalp to officially hit the reset button and remove your hair of all that buildup and that grease and grime and everything that's weighing your hair down. Now, when you are using a clarifying shampoo, you may notice that it is very foamy and very effective at cleaning, even on the first clean. But if it is not and it's not foaming up properly, your hair may just be very, very dirty. So I always recommend feeling out your hair, adding water, scrub-a-dub, dubbing it even more, and then determine if you do need that second shampoo. And don't be afraid that your hair feels squeaky and almost dry after shampooing, because that means your clarifying shampoo has done its job and leaving you with a clean canvas that you should always condition. Now, depending on what works for you, a clarifying shampoo can be used 1 to even 2 times a week. And I would advise that if you don't wash very frequently, but your hair does get quite dirty, to use a clarifying shampoo every time you wash. Although every wash may sound a little drastic, because you're not washing your hair every single day consecutively and there is buildup being accumulated on your scalp throughout the week, when it comes to wash day, you are perfectly okay to use a clarifying shampoo once a week. And in fact, if you're not washing your hair all the time, you can even get away with just having a clarifying shampoo if you don't swim, you have soft water, and you don't chemically treat your hair. If that sounds like you,
then go ahead, boo, clarify you. Unless it's just not working for you. There is one thing that a clarifying shampoo cannot chelate for you, and that is mineral buildup.
Wait, you want more? Sorry, well, hold on, look at me, I'm all washed up.
Things like minerals and metals and chlorines will attach themselves to our hair's protein in the middle of our shaft, our hair shaft. Chelating agents work to bind to these metals and minerals in the hair, similar to how surfactants work with oil and sebum on the surface of our hair. But chelating ingredients work deep, and it is these specific types of ingredients that are those active chelating agents that you should look for on your shampoos if you are looking to remove it all. These types of ingredients also work differently depending on what you're trying to remove. For example, the most common chelating complex is EDTA. Looking for EDTA on your clarifying shampoos will let you know that those are chelating. These EDTA ingredients are water-soluble solids, and they are found in many different cosmetics, but should definitely be looked out for in our clarifying types of cleansers. A chelating shampoo is a whole different category that, in my world, we consider a true clarifying shampoo. This is the shampoo that we use on very special occasions, approximately 1 to 2 times a month, always before a chemical service like a hair color or straightening service, keratin service. And anytime the hair feels like it just cannot get clean, it is limp, it is lifeless, the color has gone, not like gone, but it's tainted, it's a whole new color. Because a lot of these problems are caused by mineral buildups in hard water, from pool waters, chlorine, hard metals that are found in our water systems as well. Or even you enjoy smoking and you notice your hair color changes with that as well. All of these things can affect our hair to become drier, more damaged, greasier at the root, irritate your scalp skin, and cause color fading. All of which can be controlled with a regular use of a chelating shampoo. Not a regular clarifying shampoo. And that's why I have an issue with some of the marketing that's out there nowadays. A chelating shampoo will remove both product buildup and mineral buildup. So it's both clarifying, chelating. It is the most cleansing that you can get. That being said, it doesn't work the other way around. So a clarifying shampoo can't do the chelating that you may need for you. Now please, if any of that has resonated with you, chelate on not too frequently. And let's talk about our specialty shampoos. Now, specialty shampoos, this is an umbrella term for what I would consider our medicated shampoos. Medicated shampoos are the ones that have active drug ingredients that are made to treat conditions of the scalp. That means they don't always have the best benefits for our hair. When using a medicated shampoo, I would recommend applying with a bottle applicator directly onto your scalp. This is gonna work out way better for you and your scalp and your hair because it makes applying way easier. You get to apply directly on the affected area that needs the medication and treatment. And from there, since you usually have to let those medicated shampoos sit on the scalp for a few minutes to activate and do its thing, by applying directly on the scalp, it prevents it from reaching your ends and causing dryness and damage and even affecting your color if that's the case. Different medicated shampoos are different. And I did previously do a full video on different types of medicated shampoos that you can find at the drugstore. If you are looking for a scalp skin routine, I will link that video here. Remember to always use medicated shampoos as directed on the bottle, as instructed by not just the bottle, but by your healthcare provider, dermatologist, that can prescribe you with the proper scalp care. Other specialty treatments include our purple shampoos or blue shampoos. As these types of shampoos, although they cleanse, you're not really using these shampoos for cleansing ability. You're mostly using them to add color back to your hair. Now sometimes this can be a two-in-one. I've used purple shampoos that are also very cleansing. But when using a purple shampoo, you need to remember that it's for your ends. I have seen some people with purple scalp. That's from your purple shampoo. Staining. Purple shampoo is a shampoo that can actually be used more on your ends or wherever the color is that you want to add color to, but should definitely not be the only shampoo
you use.
If I am personally using my purple shampoo, I like to do it in twos where I will purple shampoo and then go in with my regular cleanser on my scalp if I want really, really minimal results. Or if you're looking for a little extra color, I will first cleanse the hair and scalp with my regular clarifying or even conditioning cleanser and then follow up with my purple shampoo or spot treat. Regular shampoo on the scalp, color shampoo on the ends, and you get the best of both worlds without having to shampoo twice if that's not needed for you. And I feel like I have to say this, but don't abuse your color enhancing shampoos. Those purples and those blues, they really do start to build up on the hair, and they can kind of change the whole color and tone of your hair if you're using them every single time. So I wouldn't necessarily recommend to use them every single wash, but I will leave that decision up to you to analyze your hair and know what's best for you. Know what's best for your hair color, what you prefer, or better yet, listen to your stylist. Don't make them mad. Don't ruin your blonde at home with too much purple shampoo. We've seen it. It happens. It looks dingy and gray and no longer bright. Tone it down. Tone it down a notch. Instead of shampooing so often and cleansing your hair, use a dry shampoo. Dry shampoos are a whole other category that are used without the actual use of water. So they are definitely not our conventional shampoo that we have been talking about throughout this entire video. And so dry shampoos are not going to be right for everyone. They are definitely not the only solution, but when you do need a quick fix, dry shampoos are great to remove excess oil that is on your scalp and making your hair look really weighed down. They can add a ton of volume. They can even add some color, some root touch-up. Most dry shampoos will tell you to spray at a safe distance and then let them sit on the hair for 30 seconds to a minute. In that time, the white powder that you see is going to help to cling to oils and dirt and lift them up from the hair, which then you brush away. You can even add a little blow dryer to it to kind of fluff away those excess oils. And this is actually very, very beneficial if you have an oily hair and scalp that you need to wash frequently, but you also have funky colored hair that you want to preserve. This way you're gonna get the best of both worlds. You'll feel a little bit cleaner while also not washing out your color so quickly. And this may also be a very good option if you have very dry and damaged hair from chemical treatments. Because water on the hair can make already dry and damaged hair much more vulnerable, if it's in that gummy, stretchy state, you don't even want it to get wet. You definitely don't want to brush it when it's wet. But if you are at that stage, you either cut it all off or you do use another type of specialty shampoo, which would just be your strengthening shampoo. Treatment shampoos that are going to help to add protein, keratin, biotin, strengthening type of ingredients to help fortify the hair and make it a little bit stronger in the washing process. And well, whew, I don't know about you, but after this video, I am pooped. Shampooed? I should be a shampooed. That was bad. Let me just clarify the air here. I meant no harm with those horrible dad jokes. Then again, those are not actually dad jokes. They're mom jokes, because I'm your curl mom. And I think that is a good coverage of most of the shampoos out there. If you think I missed anything or you have any questions, make sure to drop them in the comment section below. I will list for you some of my favorite product recommendations of different types of shampoos in the description box below if you want to reference or check any of them out. But while you're down there, if you did like this video, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to see more of me. More Mell means more fun. And I do have more videos just like this one already up on the channel. If you're interested in seeing this video but in conditioner version, you can see the conditioner video or scroll through the channel to find other reviews, styling tips, tutorials, all kinds of things. Be my guest. I will put the links there for you. And without further ado, don't forget to shampoo. Peace. I've been waiting for this one. And it is these conditions up here that are going to tell you what products you should adhere to.
I'm on that Dr. Seuss wave again. I just can't stop. I just can't stop rhyming. I just can't stop rhyming. It's actually a personality trait at this point, but I'm not a rapper. Super hot. Fire.
Fire!
My scalp's on fire. Scientific Melly in the house.
Get it!
Hi, Scientific Melly here.
Yeah.
Alright. Okay. I'm sweating. I'm sweating. Time to party. Time to party. I'm hungry. Are we eating now?
Yeah.
Yeah!
Yeah!
I think everything has been fire so far.
Because if you see... Damn it. No! What is happening?
If you see, I look crusty. Its whole job is to remove those excess oils and buildup and butters and dirt and soil. Soil themselves. Bow, 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 bow. I think I did it! I think I did it!